Hey there, welcome to First Glance with Jody Vance. This is a resource for people who are trying to figure out how to get into the markets, maybe take that hard-earned little nest egg and start to invest somewhere. We're introducing you to companies that are really on the verge of busting out big time, emerging companies like that sweet spot. We try and find that sweet spot and get it out to the masses. So it's not just for people fancy expensive suits with pocket squares and inside Intel. It is for you right here on First Glance with Jody Vance. And today we have DIAGNOS Inc. President Andre Lerente with us. Andre, thanks for doing this.
Nice to meet you and everybody.
Well, let's talk about DIAGNOS Inc. I've done a little bit of scratching the surface here and I'm fascinated. So can you give us sort of the Coles notes, the elevator talk, if you will, about what DIAGNOS Inc. is all about?
Sure. DIAGNOS is an AI company, so artificial intelligence. We've been doing AI for probably 15 years, and we now have focused our attention on an unmet need in the medical sector, and it's for people that are diabetic or suffer from hypertension. So we analyze the back of the eye, the retina, and we can actually save people from going blind, and we can actually save the governments and organizations like hospitals and HMOs from spending too much money, because we're going to be doing this to actually find patients that need attention in the early stage of their disease.
And so give me, Give me a for example on that. How would somebody get their eyes scanned by way of your technology? Where does it happen?
So our technology is in production and it's now live. And the way you access the technology platform is through your hospitals, your clinics. Very soon, we'll be in many optometry stores in Canada. We already have 65 stores in the U.S. So you'll be able to go to a different setting. You know, today with the COVID, nobody wants to walk into a hospital for their annual visit to their endocrinologist. And the endocrinologist is the doctor that looks after diabetic patients. So if we do this test, it's a medical test, that if we can do it outside the hospital, we can actually secure the people from, making sure they don't catch this COVID. So we will go, we'll be into installed in optometry stores, in primary care settings. We also have outdoor clinics that we're working on and so forth.
Can you give me an idea of what it looks like? Do you walk into something? Do you put your face into something? Does somebody use an operative tool?
Yeah, so to take a picture of the back of your eye, it's a very simple camera. It's called a fundus camera. So it's a camera that weighs about 40 pounds. It's not very sophisticated. You approach your face to it, and actually the operator will take a picture. It's just a flash, so it's not a, it doesn't hurt, and you don't have to have any drops in your eye. And so it takes flash, goes into the back of your eye, and takes the picture of the back of your eye. And what you see in the back of your eye are blood vessels like arteries and veins. And if you are a diabetic, you have 50% chance that you will develop disease on the retina. So diabetic patients are very sensitive of becoming blind due to the diabetes.
So this is truly a breakthrough that we've heard. Pardon my novice here. I'm clearly not an expert on medical nor AI, but as a journalist, I've spent a great deal of time speaking to just how much artificial intelligence might radically change and improve medical processes, if you will. This is an example of how AI can really come and be a game changer for so many.
Yes, absolutely. The AI, an AI engine, a real AI, not analytics, but an AI engine, actually can do the same thing as what a doctor and a specialist will do. In our case, it's a picture, and it's a very complex picture because you're looking for many different diseases on the retina. So this is very good for an AI setting because we have trained our artificial intelligence with 400,000 patients. So 800,000 eyeballs, if you want. And with those 400,000 patients, we're able to actually look at about 40 types of different disease in the retina. So with that quantity of data, we actually can optimize these algorithms or the AI to actually do a very, very good job and very precise. So the ophthalmologist and the retina specialist, they love what we do because we're doing the triage for the specialist. I'll give you an example. So in a hospital setting, a very big hospital, you'll have a department that takes care of diabetics. And you have a department that looks after ophthalmology, so the your eye doctor. So what we're going to do, or what we are doing today, is actually making sure that we triage the people, the diabetics, in the endocrinology department at the GP level, endocrinology level, and also at the optometry level. And we actually find the patients that need to go to the specialist. By doing this, we can cut the lineup to go see a specialist by 65 to 70%.
Wow.
In a normal environment, you're looking at 18 to 36 months before going to see a specialist. We can cut that down now to 5 to 6 months.
And put those who are at highest risk in the right order. Yeah.
In the front of the line. Absolutely. You got it.
This sounds very, very promising. I want to let people know at this point, if you're looking for the stock symbol, it is ADK. ADK is the stock symbol. Diagnosis Inc. Andre Lerente is the president of Diagnosis Inc. and is here to tell us sort of where we're at in terms of development, coming to market, this emerging moment that your company is at right now. Is this AI, is this technology being used anywhere in the world at this moment?
Yes. When we developed the platform, we went to 16 different countries. The reason why we did that, we want to make sure that our technology was a multicultural technology, if you want. So today we're actually focused more on 6 countries, Latin America, Europe, US, Canada, and Turkey. So that's where we're focusing our attention. In the Middle East, we're very specifically in Saudi Arabia and UAE for now, but we're looking at expanding very soon. We actually announced a deal last week with a very large group of hospitals in Saudi Arabia. And in Saudi, the COVID there is not as bad as in other countries. They probably have less than 200 patients a day that have been identified as COVID compared to US or Canada and stuff like that. So it's a very good country to implement our technology.
Well, that's good to know that it is being used in practice in those practical terms, if you will, at the access. So I guess the only stumbling block here, if it is as impactful as you explain, is how to perhaps overcome those who might be skeptical of this sort of artificial intelligence coming into play. Oh, who are the naysayers and why would they?
Well, actually, the neat thing about AI in the healthcare, it's now really being adopted. I think the specialists, the doctors, the optometrists, they see the benefit of having AI looking at an image, and it's very precise. It's a lot more precise than a human being. And we look at these images every day, so we can do thousands of images a day. A human being cannot do that. These images are very colorful, lots of blood vessels, a lot of disease. And after a point, you can't see clear. Before noon, you're not too bad. After noon, you can't see as much because our eyes are the weakness to what we have to deal with. But the technology has been proven. We have FDA approval, Health Canada approval. We have a lot of approvals that you actually need to go into these sectors. We also are an ISO certified company. So for the people who don't understand ISO, ISO is a quality management system that actually helps us make sure that we don't screw up, that we monitor everything, everything's in writing. And before you get an FDA approval, you have to have an ISO certification. And same thing in other countries. So these certifications are very important for our future, and we have them. And that's been probably a very big task, but we have them now.
Having that certification, having that seal of approval, if you will, that gives credit to the technology that you're putting forward. Because what I'm hearing from you, Andre, is that this is yet another important tool in the toolkit of a physician who is legitimately working at the speed of light, trying to save as many eyes as humanly possible. It's literally the difference between blindness and complete recovery if identified enough. This is breakthrough stuff.
Absolutely. I mean, I'm doing this, because we believe that the technology can help our patients. We're very close to hospital general managers, directors, CEO of hospitals, and the benefit for the patient. And so it's very good. On the other end, too, there's less risk for a company like us at Diagnos because we have money, we have the certifications, we have very large clients that are coming on board. And we are so multinational in the sense that we're not only Canadian or US, we've already have customers in US and Canada and other countries, and it gives us a much bigger market to play with.
Broad base. Again, the stock symbol is ADK, ADK, Diagnosis Inc. Andre Lerente is the president who is with us. Now, can I ask a little bit about you and the company structure? And if somebody watching this right now thinks, you know what, I want to invest in this. So how do they get in touch? How do they get more information? If they want to learn more about how this is emerging, growing, and get more details into it, how does one go about that?
Well, they can come to the Diagnos website, so www.diagnos.ca.com. We are on the TSX Venture in Toronto, so it's the big exchange. So you can find a lot of information there because we're public. You know, all our filings are up to date and so forth. So there's a lot of information. You can call me. Very flexible in terms of calling back investors and making sure that we talk to them. I do a lot of conferences also, virtual conferences, to explain how AI can actually benefit people that are in the healthcare environment, like nurses, GPs, optometrists. And right now, I think we're taking the time. I know COVID is affecting everybody, but COVID is going to stop, you know, probably mid-year. And we're actually signing a lot of business and getting people ready for when this thing takes off. And it's going to take off. And it's going to be here for a long time. It is a sustainable environment.
Hit the ground running, as it were. I love it when people talk about COVID-19 being in its last legs. We're all looking forward to, and everybody feels like, it feels like this energy ready to let the horses run as soon as we can get back to some semblance of normalcy. And certainly, even when these diagnostic tools could be used in person at a physician's appointment, what you said earlier is really sticking with me in terms of the screening process, of streamlining how you find the patient who really needs that front of the line access, need being the key word here. It does have that sort of intrinsic wellness piece to this business puzzle. And I also love the fact that you say, you can call me because I'll call you back if you're an investor.
Giving accessibility at a very low cost. Our test is very, very low cost. The idea is to make sure that everybody can afford it. So we're talking tests between $10 and $20. So everybody can afford that. And so...
How much is the unit to install? Like the hardware, the software, the full package?
Yeah, I found this camera costs about $18,000, but they're good for the next 10 years. Yeah. So you can amortize it 7 years and there's no issue. So the customers we have either have those cameras already, or we can provide it, and we put the additional cost in the transaction cost. So instead of paying $10, you'll pay maybe $15, and right. That's it. So the idea is to bring that technology close to the patient. So put them in the primary clinics all around the U.S., in optometry stores. And the neat thing about optometry stores, a lot of them have a fundus camera already.
Right.
We have an open platform. We work with all the different types of cameras out there.
So your AI is looking through these photos of the back of the eye of the retina and identifying where the issues might be. And doing it at a speed a human being just simply could not do. Before I let you go, I can't believe we're almost out of time here, but before I let you go, Andre, I want to ask about you as an individual, as an investor, as a business person. Do you remember what your first investment was?
Oh, absolutely. I graduated in computer science, and my first paycheck, my father always told me, you got to take a little bit and put it away. And I invested in a company called Northern Telecom. And Northern Telecom was a big success in Canada.
Yeah.
That was my first investment.
Applause to you and applause to your dad. I got the exact same piece of advice. And boy, he said to me when I was 15 years old, my first job, he said, you don't know what compound interest means right now, but let me tell you, one day you will. And he was right. So, Andre, very much for sharing some of the insights about your company, as well as giving us an opportunity to get to know you. This is all very exciting, and I hope that you circle back and keep us updated on all things Diagnosis Inc. And as again, ADK, the stock symbol, we'll be watching it closely.
Thank you very much. What?